talent tape, I'm assuming. What stands out with those guys?
I haven't seen much of them on tape. We're probably about to watch it right before practice today, but I watched them play, and they can shoot the ball very well. They're somewhat similar to Mercer because they can shoot the ball and they run their offense well and ball screen. Defense will be important for us.
Jordan, how much do you think you guys are getting out of this kind of, I don't know about it, Cinderella, it doesn't seem like the right word for the way you guys play. Being the low seed and kind of the underdog, is that, you think, you know, bringing guys together in the locker room, like nobody believes in us?
That's definitely been one of our motivations. Just knowing that we have talent, you know, I wouldn't call us a Cinderella because, you know, we have guys who are highly recruited out of high school, so, and we have veterans, so I wouldn't call us a Cinderella. But it's definitely motivation that people have doubted us, and we've been in so many close games this year, and we just haven't found a way to win up until now. So this is the right time to be winning.
How much different has it been? You know, you guys show up, get back on campus on late Sunday, and there's, you know, a little crowd here to see you guys. How much different has it been the last couple of days here on campus?
I've received a lot of attention everywhere I go, and I'm sort of salty about it, I would say. I'm sort of mad about it because it's people who I've been seeing all this time, and they would say, oh, hey, Jarnell, and now when they see me, it's sort of, they get a little more excited. So, you know, you have to stay humble throughout the process because you have to know it can come and go.
How do you think Coach Martin will keep you guys kind of grounded now that you're kind of having to deal with some success after all, you know, some of the negativity that was there during the season?
I'm not sure how he'll handle the situation. I'm sure he has something planned up, and I guess we'll see today and the rest of the week.
Jordan, how did you find all that in Raleigh? Just, you know, the media, the locker rooms are open, you know, cameras, TV stations from all over the country there. I mean, was it much of a distraction, or did it make things feel different?
You said in Raleigh?
Yeah, I mean, just once it got so big over there, especially in the weekend.
I don't really see it as a distraction. I feel like when the stage is set, I feel like I probably have some of my best games. But I feel like these last couple games in the tournament, I don't feel like I played my best basketball. Like, I missed a lot of easy layups, a lot of rebounds. I got off to a slow start against Iowa, so I'm still beating myself up about that. But, you know, I'm looking forward, and I feel like I can play a lot better.
What's been the difference in Tennessee's defense this last couple of weeks?
Energy, enthusiasm, guys are passionate about stopping their man, playing defense. We're holding each other accountable and we're trusting each other a lot.
Looks like you're playing better as a team too, defensively.
Yeah, like I said, we're trusting each other a lot. When there is a breakdown, we instantly, you know, solve it. We go straight to the source. No one is getting offended by that. And therefore, if we're holding each other accountable, it's harder for you to make mistakes, and we realize that it's not okay. You know, can't let the coach be the only one telling you what's good and what's bad on the defensive end.
Michigan likes to shoot the three ball. They want to light it up from outside. How important is it that you guys stick to playing inside out against a team that would be easy to get up trying to outshoot from the three-point line?
Michigan likes to shoot the ball, and sadly, on teams like that, they can be hot at any night. So sometimes you have to be a little bit lucky when hoping that they don't hit a lot of shots, hoping that they miss some, maybe get off to a slow start. But, we definitely have to continue playing our game plan, do what got us here, and, you know, having a balanced type of offense.
Y'all been playing with so little margin for error these last few weeks after you got to that 10-11 loss mark. How did that help prepare you for when you got to the tournament situation? In fact, you've kind of been playing these do-or-die games for a while now.
I don't know. I think everything just clicked. I think this year the team is a lot different from previous years because we see it all coming to an end. You know, guys are hungry because we're older. We've been in the NIT twice, and it's a terrible feeling to almost make the tournament. So. And it's just sort of continued on throughout the season.
Jordan, how much do you think that Iowa game was maybe a springboard for this rest of this run? It seems like you guys came out timid in that game, and since then it's kind of been.
Yeah, I feel like guys were a little shy against Iowa. I sort of was suffering from riding the bus there the entire time. So I felt stiff coming out, and I'm glad I had a good second half. But to go back, I feel like throughout the season, we've had a lot of close games, and we've lost a lot of close games. So I wouldn't say we were a bad team. We just never figured out how to win games. And I would much rather be where we at right now than like a Wichita State or certain teams like that.
Talk about the close game. Did winning that one the way it was, the way it came down the stretch there in the second half, do you think that you guys have a lot more confidence going into the next two?
I wouldn't say the way it was. I feel like we got back to playing the way we play. We got a lot of key stops, and the energy was there, and guys hit shots. And it basically led into the next game. We came out hitting shots against UMass also.
How strange was that to deal with the bus ride? Had many of those. To have that one of those for your biggest game of the season,
I hate it. I hate it. As a bigger guy, I hate sitting in the bus for 5 hours. So I think we're riding the bus again to Indianapolis. So we're flying. Okay. Good. Good. Okay.
A lot of the perimeter shooters talking about having to make an adjustment when they play in one of these huge stadiums like the Georgia Dome and this place where you play. Is it different for an inside guy?
I don't think it's different at all. I don't think it's different.
Because you're not shooting from the perimeter, I guess.
I wouldn't say. I feel like, guys have been shooting better. As far as on our team, we've been shooting better in the tournament and on these big stages. So I don't think stadium has anything to do with that.